I decided just on a whim in my early 20s to go get involved in a project in Central America monitoring birds. Your first trip to a tropical rainforest is really nothing like anything you experienced before. You see it on television, you see it in the books, and it's pretty easy to understand why it'd be really pretty, but then when you go there, it really is overwhelming. It really just solidified what I wanted to do the rest of my life. One of my major focuses is looking at the avian tree of life, and the part of the tree I'm looking at are the really recent events, the formation of new species, and I'm particularly looking at tropical birds. Many of these groups of birds just haven't been studied thoroughly. What we're finding is that the diversity is greatly underestimated. And so a lot of the work that I've been doing and will be doing in the coming years is really trying to get a better handle on what is the diversity of tropical birds. So right now in biology, we're going through what is called the genomic revolution. And so we have advances in DNA sequencing technology that really changed the entire landscape. We now have a much more comprehensive resource that gives us insight into how organisms evolve by looking across their entire genomes. We use specimens of birds where we can get a tissue source to get our DNA, or we use really old specimens which serve as a source for what is called ancient DNA. The Carolina parakeet, it was the only species of parrot that was found in the United States. It went extinct in the early 1900s, and we know very little about this species. But what we do have here in the collection is a really nice series of specimens collected in the late 1800s that provide insights and maybe even to why it went extinct. Tree thinking, or the application of evolutionary trees to other fields of biology, has become pervasive. And so whether in the fields of ecology, human medicine, conservation biology, what we found out is that if you include the evolutionary history of an organism into your study, you can have a much more thorough understanding of whatever process you're trying to study. So resolving the avian tree of life will not only be a helpful tool for ornithologists and evolutionary biologists, it's going to be a tool that can be incorporated in many fields of science.